गुड मॉर्निंग स्टूडेंट्स, वेलकम टू टाटा कैम डीएवी पब्लिक स्कूल मीठापुर ऑनलाइन क्लासेस। माइसेल्फ कविता मोदी, योर मैथ्स टीचर फॉर क्लास 5। टुडे वी आर गोइंग टू स्टार्ट चैप्टर 3, मल्टीपल्स एंड फैक्टर्स। इन दिस चैप्टर आवर टॉपिक्स आर फैक्टर्स, रिमेंबर सम इम्पोर्टेंट पॉइंट्स, हाइएस्ट कॉमन फैक्टर एंड सम एग्जाम्पल्स। वॉट इज फैक्टर्स? अ फैक्टर इज अ नंबर that divides the number exactly with 0 as the remainder. For example, is 4 a factor of 24? To know is 4 is the factor of 24, we simply divide 24 by 4 and find out if the remainder is 0 or not. If we divide 24 by 4, we get the quotient as 6 and remainder as 0. So what does this imply? After the division, if the remainder is equal to 0, it tells us that the divisor is a factor of the dividend. So we say that 4 is a factor of 24. It is also means 24 is divisible by 4. In short, the factor of a number is an exact divisor of that number. See the next example. 5 is a factor of 24. To know the answer, let's try dividing 24 by 5. 5 times 4 is equal to 20, and 24 minus 20 is equal to 4. So we get the quotient is equal to 4 and the remainder is equal to 4. Since the remainder is not equal to 0, we can say that 5 is not a factor of 24. That's how we find out if the number is a factor of another or not. So a factor is nothing but an exact divisor of a number. Let's solve one more example. Find all the factors of 24. To find the factors of 24, first we divide 24 by 1 and find out the remainder is 0 or not. If we divide 24 by 1, we get quotient is equal to 24 and remainder is equal to 0. So 1 is a factor of 24. Then we divide 24 by 2. We get quotient as 12 and remainder is equal to 0. So 2 is a factor of 24. Then we divide 24 by 3. We get the quotient as 8 and remainder is equal to 0. So 3 is a factor of 24. Then divide 24 by 4. We get the quotient is equal to 6 and remainder is equal to 0. So 4 is a factor of 24. Then we divide 24 by 5. We get the quotient is equal to 4 and remainder is also 4. So 5 is not a factor of 24. So leave 5, then divide 24 by 6. We get the quotient is equal to 4 and remainder is equal to 0. See, if we divide 24 by 4 and 24 by 6, we will get the same multiplication fact. 4 multiply 6 is equal to 24 and 6 multiply 4 is equal to 24. If we get same multiplication fact, stop here. Therefore, the factors of 24 are 1 and 24, 2 and 12, 3 and 8, and 4 and 6. Remember, always write the factors in ascending order. Thus, the factor of 24 is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 8, 12, and 24. Answer the following question. Question number A. Is 7 a factor of 77? And the answer is yes, because if we divide 77 by 7, then quotient is equal to 11 and remainder is equal to 0. And if the remainder is equal to 0, we can say that 7 is a factor of 77. Question number B. Is 8 a factor of 62? And the answer is no, because if we divide 62 by 8, then quotient is equal to 7 and remainder is equal to 6. And if the remainder is not equal to 0, we can say that 8 is not a factor of 62. Question number C. Is 9 a factor of 70? And the answer is no, because if we divide 70 by 9, then quotient is equal to 7 and remainder is also equal to 7. And if the remainder is not equal to 0, we can say that 9 is not a factor of 70. Question number D. Is 12 a factor of 120? And the answer is yes, because if we divide 120 by 12, then the quotient is equal to 10 and remainder is equal to 0. Question number E. Is 15 a factor of 100? And the answer is no, because if we divide 100 by 15, then the quotient is equal to 6 and remainder is equal to 10. Question number F. Is 20 a factor of 140? And the answer is yes, because if we divide 140 by 20, then quotient is equal to 7 and remainder is equal to 0. And if remainder is equal to 0, we can say that 20 is a factor of 140. There are one more method to find the factors. Let's see. Multiplying two whole numbers give a product. The numbers that we multiply are the factors of the product. For example, 2 multiplied by 4 is equal to 8. So 2 and 4 are the factors of the product 8. See the next example. 3 multiplied by 4 is equal to 12. So 3 and 4 are the factors of 12. Also, 2 multiplied by 6 is equal to 12. So 2 and 6 are also the factors of 12. And 1 multiplied by 12 is equal to 12. So 1 and 12 are the factors of 12. So the factors of 12 are 3 and 4, 2 and 6, 1 and 12. But always we will write the factors in ascending order. So the factors of 12 is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 6 and 12. You have to remember some important points to find the factors. Number 1. Factors are always whole numbers or integers and never decimals or fractions. Number 2. All even numbers will have number 2 as their factor. Number 3. All numbers that end with 5 will have 5 as their factor. Number 4. All numbers greater than 0 and ending with a 0 will have 2, 5 and 10 as their factors. Number 5. Algebraic expressions are often solved or simplified through factoring. Number 6. The number 1 is the smallest factor of every number. Number 7. When listing factors, always start with 1 and number itself. Number 8. Always write the factors in ascending order. Number 9. We count the repeated factor only once. Number 10. Every number except 1 has at least 2 factors, 1 and number itself. Number 11. The factor of a number is always equal to or less than the number. Number 12. 1 is the common factor of any 2 or more numbers. Let's solve the exercise. Fill in the blanks. Question number 1. 2 multiplied by 7 is equal to 14. 2 and dash are the factors of 14. What we have to write in blanks? The answer is 7. Question number 2. 3 multiplied by 8 is equal to 24. Dash and 8 are the factors of 24. What we have to write in blanks? The answer is 3. Question number 3. 5 multiplied by 7 is equal to 35. 5 and 7 are the factors of dash and the answer is 35. Let's solve the next question. Write all the factors of the following numbers. How to find all the factors of 28? First, we write 28 as a product of two numbers. We have to think of all the possible combination of 28. Remember, when listing factors, always start with 1 and number itself. So 28 can be written as 1 multiplied by 28 is equal to 28. Then we move on the 2. Is 28 divisible by 2? Yes. The product can be written as 2 multiplied by 14 is equal to 28. Is 28 divisible by 3? No, it is not. So leave them. Take the next number 4. 24 is divisible by 4? Yes. And the product can be written as 4 multiplied by 7 is equal to 28. Then move on 5. Is 28 divisible by 5? No, it is not. So leave them. Take the next number 6. Is 28 divisible by 6? No, it is not. So leave them also. Then we move on 7, which is already covered here. When we know that we had covered all the possible product of two numbers, so the factors of 28 is equal to 1, 2, 4, 7, 14 and 28. Let's try to find the factors of 45. We have to think of all the possible combination of 45. If we listing factors always start with 1 and number itself. So 45 can be written as 1 multiplied by 45 is equal to 45. Take the next number 2. Is 45 completely divisible by 2? No, it is not. So leave them. Take the next number 3. Is 45 completely divisible by 3? Yes. If you have any doubt, divide and check. The quotient is equal to 15 and remainder is equal to 0. So the product can be written as 3 multiplied 15 is equal to 45. Then we move on 4. Is 45 completely divisible by 4? No, it is not. So leave them. Then take 5. Is 45 completely divisible by 5? Yes, the product can be written as 5 multiplied by 9 is equal to 45. Then we move on 6. Is 45 completely divisible by 6? No. So leave them. Then take 7. Is 45 completely divisible by 7? No. So leave them. Then take 8. 45 is completely divisible by 8? No. So leave them. Then we move on 9, which is already covered here. When we know that we had covered all possible product of two numbers. So stop here. So write down all the factors of 45 in ascending order. So the factors of 45 is equal to 1, 3, 5, 9, 15 and 45. Let's try to find the factors of 35. It is very simple. Write the number as a product of two numbers. We have to think of all the possible combination of 35. If you listing factors always start with 1 and number itself. So 35 can be written as 1 multiplied by 35 is equal to 35. Is 35 completely divisible by 2? No, it is not. So leave them. Take the next number 3. Is 35 completely divisible by 3? No, it is not. So leave them. Then take 4. Is 35 completely divisible by 4? No, it is not. So leave 4 also. Then take 5. Is 35 completely divisible by 5? Yes. So the product can be written as 5 multiplied by 7 is equal to 35. Take the next number 6. Is 35 completely divisible by 6? No, it is not. So leave them. Then we move on the 7, which is already covered here. When we know that we had covered all the possible product of two numbers. The numbers covered are in U shape and all these numbers are the factors of 35. So the factors of 35 is equal to 1, 5, 7 and 35. Question number D. Let's try to find all the factors of 60. We have to think of all the possible combination of 60. Everyone know if we listing factors always start with 1 and number itself. So 60 can be written as 1 multiplied by 60 is equal to 60. 60 is completely divisible by 2 also. So the product can be written as 2 multiplied by 30 is equal to 60. 60 is completely divisible by 3 also. So product can be written as 3 multiplied by 20 is equal to 60. 60 is completely divisible by 4 also. So the product can be written as 4 multiplied by 15 is equal to 60. 60 is completely divisible by 5 also. So the product can be written as 5 multiplied by 12 is equal to 60. Next, 60 is completely divisible by 6 also. So the product can be written as 6 multiplied by 10 is equal to 60. But 60 is not divisible by 7, 8 and 9. So leave them. And then we move on 10, which is already come here. So the factors of 60 is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 10, 12, 15, 20, 30 and 60. Let's take the next question. Find the factors of 71. Think all the possible combination of 71. Always start listing the factors with 1 and number itself. So 71 can be written as 1 multiplied by 71 is equal to 71. But 71 is not divisible by any number other than 1 and 71. So the factors of 71 is equal to 1 and 71. Let's take the next question. Find all the factors of 96. Now we have to think of all possible combination of 96. First start with 1. 1 multiplied by 96 is equal to 96. It can also be written as 2 multiplied by 48 is equal to 96. It can also be written as 3 multiplied by 32 is equal to 96. Wait, it can be written as 4 multiplied by 24 is equal to 96. Are any more combination? Yes, it can be written as 6 multiplied by 16 is equal to 96. And it can also be written as 8 multiplied by 12 is equal to 96. That's it. There is no other product of two numbers that would be result is 96. So the factors of 96 is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 8, 12, 16, 24, 32, 48 and 96. Hope you understand how to find the factors. Let us learn about the highest common factor, or you can call it HCF2. What is HCF? Let us understand the meaning of the term common factors. When two or more numbers have the same numbers as their factors, those factors are said to be common factors. Now let us see what do we mean by the highest common factor. The highest or greatest common factor of two or more numbers is the greatest number that is a factor of those numbers. To understand it in a better way, let's solve some examples. Find the HCF of the following. Question number A, 20 and 30. Everyone know how we will find out the factors. So first find out the factors of 20 like this. Then find out the factors of 30 like this. Step 1. Factors of 20 is equal to 1, 2, 4, 5, 10 and 20. Factors of 30 is equal to 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 10, 15 and 30. Step 2. Find out the common factor. So common factors of 20 and 30 is equal to 1, 2, 5 and 10. Step 3. Find out the HCF. So HCF of 20 and 30 is equal to 10. Let's solve the next question. Question number B. Find the highest common factor of 10, 16 and 23. First, we will find out the factor of 10 like this. Then we will find out the factors of 16 like this. And then we will find out the factors of 23 like this. Step 1. Factors of 10 is equal to 1, 2, 5 and 10. Factors of 16 is equal to 1, 2, 4, 8 and 16. And factors of 23 is equal to 1 and 23 only. Step 2. Find the common factor. So common factors of 10, 16 and 23 is equal to 1. Step 3, find the HCF. So HCF of 10, 16 and 23 is equal to 1. Let's solve the next question. Question number C. Find the HCF of 20, 30 and 40. Everyone know how we will find out the factors. So first we will find out the factors of 20 like this. Then we will find out the factors of 30 like this. And then we will find out the factors of 40 like this. Always write the factors in ascending order. Step 1. First we will write all the factors of 20, 30 and 40. So factors of 20 is equal to 1, 2, 4, 5, 10 and 20. Then factors of 30 is equal to 1, 2, 3, 5, 6, 10, 15 and 30. Factors of 40 is equal to 1, 2, 4, 5, 8, 10, 20 and 40. Step 2. Then we will find out the common factors. So common factors of 20, 30 and 40 is equal to 1, 2, 5 and 10. Step 3. Then we will find out the HCF of 20, 30 and 40. So highest common factor of 20, 30 and 40 is equal to 10. Let's solve the next question. Question number D. Find the HCF of 10, 16 and 23. First we will find out the factors of 10 like this. Then we will find out the factors of 16 like this. And then we will find out the factors of 23 like this. So the factors of 10 is equal to 1, 2, 5 and 10. Factors of 16 is equal to 1, 2, 4, 8 and 16. And factors of 23 is equal to 1 and 23 only. Let's find the common factors. So the common factors of 10, 16 and 23 is equal to 1 only. And the HCF of 10, 16 and 23 is equal to 1. Let's solve one more question. Question number E. Find the HCF of 8, 24 and 36. First, we will write the factors of 8 like this. Then we will write the factors of 24 like this. And then we will write the factors of 36 like this. Then we will write all the factors in ascending order like this. Factors of 8 is equal to 1, 2, 4 and 8. Then factors of 24 is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 8, 12 and 24. And the factors of 36 is equal to 1, 2, 3, 4, 6, 9, 12, 18 and 36. Then we will find out the common factors. So common factors of 8, 24 and 36 is equal to 1, 2 and 4. Then we will find out the HCF. So highest common factor of 8, 24 and 36 is equal to 4. For the last question, question number F, find the HCF of 5, 25 and 35. First we will write the factors of 5 like this. Then we will write the factors of 25 like this. And then we will write the factors of 35 like this. So factors of 5 is equal to 1 and 5. Then factors of 25 is equal to 1, 5 and 25. And the factors of 35 is equal to 1, 5, 7 and 35. Then we will find out the common factors. So common factors of 5, 25 and 35 is equal to 1 and 5. Then we will find out the HCF. So highest common factor of 5, 25 and 35 is equal to 5. Hope you better understand HCF. Hope you will understand how we will find out the factors and HCF. Learn and write all the important points in your MCW and complete worksheet 5 and 6 of lesson 3 in your MCW. Thank you. Have a nice day.